But then the gas must have backed up inside or something, because the cow f***ing exploded.
Whoa. Sup, everyone? I hope you all are doing amazing on the 1st of July. Hope you're all staying safe. And welcome back to the channel. If you're new to the channel, welcome. If you have shown some love, thank you. You know, I'm here, and if you're here, I suppose, you know, we all are here for the love of cinema. And for today, on a Thursday, we're doing Thursday shorts, because we respect short films, and for a lot of, you know, directors, that's how they either make it through to a feature film, you know, like somebody like Damien Chazelle, or, you know, different directors to either get funding or to get their name out there. They make short films, and if that's their bread, you know, that's their like bread and butter before, you know, feature films. And I think, you know, as Werner Herzog said, you know, short films are, in fact, you know, they can sometimes be even harder than a feature film, because you have only a certain amount of time to, you know, divulge into the characters and the story. And you know it's easy to stereotype short films as being like almost student work, because, you know, that's the conventional length of, you know, student projects. But I think even like one of my favorite short films that I you know even have on my phone is a Pitch Black Heist with Michael Fassbender, and I know it won a BAFTA in either 2012 or 13. I'm pretty sure it was 2012. But just seeing how that film, in a, you know, it was a, and I know the director also made Slow West as a short film before it went to a feature, but, you know, just seeing how it went from, you know, it's black and white. I don't know how big the budget was, but it was, you know, you got two good actors and you have a really good screenplay. And I think, you know, for people that are masters in general of film, doesn't matter the length, you're really able to command viewers' attention. And, you know, just look at Damien Chazelle's new spot for Apple's vertical recording. I mean, big budget, yes, but at the same time, it's powerful, fun, fast, exciting, all of the above. And we love it. We love short films here. And today we're going to watch one entitled Six Shooter. It's in 2004. It won an Academy Award. That's all I know about it. But we're going to continue every Thursday for Thursday Shorts. So we're going to get right into it. And again, if you're watching for the first time, thank you. If you're a returning guest, thank you. If you have subscribed, thank you. If you're watching and don't like it and give a dislike, thank you. If you watch it and like it, thank you. In all cases, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for pushing film forward. Thank you for consuming content. Thank you. Thank you. July 1st is a day of thanks. Actually, every day is a day of thanks, but thank you. Okay, we're going to get right into it. Let's go. Missing in action in a funny farm films. You know, I love some of the way, you know, I love some of the ways different directors, you know, when they're starting out, they, you know, they have their own production company, and I love some of the names, you know, Quentin Tarantino's and Spike Lee's 40 Acres and a Mule.
Oh, yes, please. Thank you.
I remember that actor only from one film, and that's obviously from Mission Impossible.
You run off your feet, you're... Two cadets and a woman. Her son shot the poor head off her.
No.
Okay, something already seems strange.
Don't know what to say.
Say, you can say anything.
I brought you the photo of David.
David the Rabbit.
Don't know what to say. I don't know where you are now.
Oh no, that's creepy. That's creepy. You don't touch somebody like that. Okay, pacing is quite slow, but I like that it's taking its time. Where, I guess, yeah, we're going to be following this character. We're going to be with this character for at least trying to get into his head, but not much to go off of.
Anyone sitting here?
Oh, aye. There's hundreds of fellas like. Look at them.
Simple question.
It was, aye. They were the best type of questions. Some hard I can't stand.
Smoking. Smoking in the train? Quite strange. Oh, I like that. I like that they're all strangers. Maybe this is something that, you know, something transpires in the train. Six shooters. Okay. I have a feeling the rest of the story is going to take place on this train.
How about you? Seem a bit down in the dumps, like.
Just mind your own business.
Exactly. Mind your own business.
He's a bit huffy.
Of course, he is.
Why is it you never get tall jockeys? Always sort of midgety sort of fellas.
The weight.
I know the weight.
Are you? No, there are tall jockeys.
Now, in the case of tall fellas who want to be jockeys, that's patently f***ing untrue.
Sure, jump.
You could show jump. You're just clutching at f***ing straws now. Dressage. There's another nerves.
Would you mind watching your bloody language?
No, don't get your money out, because if you think I can be arsed looking cups of tea up and down for you, you've got another thing coming by.
How hospitable.
No matter.
What's up with this? Everybody's just worrying about each other's business?
50p for a bag of potatoes. I cannot believe the gall of the ginger little
That's the same thing I say, man.
Where's the old smiley twins?
Their son died last night.
Oh no.
Did he? Did they kill it?
It.
I'm surprised mams and dads don't kill their kids more often.
Wow.
Most kids have something rotten.
Wow.
Rod Steiger, aye. And he's a
man, this guy has a lot of things to say. A lot of very opinionated.
See, I needed some heroin and a accent, so I thought I'd head straight to the source line.
If you use that language one more time, I'm gonna come over there and be
Oh no.
I was here before all ye spas!
All ye. Well, he was there. He was the first one there.
I'm not defending you no more, okay? Got my own troubles.
Okay, we have alliances now.
Here, I have this great story about a cow with trapped wind. Do you want to hear it?
No!
Just shut up! Every time we cut to the scenery, we go to everything different. We go from, you know, middle class to sheep to horse.
So, whilst you sell spirits,
don't you be getting ratty with me.
Yeah, well, don't you be getting ratty with me.
How was I getting ratty with you?
Your general face was ratty.
Working a train.
Well, is it my fault? Did you job?
I didn't say I had a job.
Everybody is sniping at each other.
You're not supposed to go up and down, no?
Everybody is having a bad day.
Is that your dead kid?
Oh man, what a question to ask.
Everyone knows it's your lumped with an ugly baby who disgraced you.
Oh no. Oh shoot. Hey man, they're mourning. Leave them alone.
I think you might have gone a bit overboard there, fella.
You think? Whoa, what was that? Oh no, 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 no. Oh shoot. Ooh, she jumped. We got a jumper. Okay, now it's getting interesting. Now it's getting interesting.
Did you see where my wife went to?
I did, aye. She flung herself off the train 5 minutes back, dashed her brains to mucking in a wall there.
Holy, he just divulged the truth all like that.
That's him.
He kept the picture. Should have given it back to the husband.
Can I keep this?
Work away, aye. Put it in your dead baby stroke Bronski beat lookalike file.
Man.
I was telling her my story about this cow with trapped wind. Oh, jeez. That wouldn't have sent her over the edge, would it, mister?
This guy has no guilty conscience. Oh, poor guy. Okay, question is the husband back on the train?
Get that train stopped!
Jeez! You're so maudlin. You didn't even know the woman.
You no respect for the dead, no?
She was getting on your nerves too with her bawling.
Oh, come on now. Get on with it.
Sure, my mam got murdered last night, but you don't see me off wailing like a spa.
Everybody has somebody that passed away.
You don't seem upset about it.
Well, she wasn't the most pleasant of women, and sure, life goes on.
My wife died last night.
Did she?
No.
I thought we had a serial killer on the loose.
Oh, man. Now he's crying.
Anna, don't cry, Alfreda. She's up with God now.
And don't patronize.
Of course you believe in God.
No.
Uh-oh.
Today was the last straw.
Oh, aye, your wife and old Mrs. Trainsurf woman.
Hmm.
Here, do you want to hear me story about the cow with trapped wind? It's a f***ing deadly story.
Go on.
It's expanding like a mad thing. Starts f***ing ballooning up.
No, my gosh.
And jumps into the pen. And everybody's going, oh, f*** no, like. And we all...
What on earth is happening?
Stab the f***. So everybody...
With trapped wind. Wow.
But then he started giving us his whole life story about what an expert he is on f***ing cows. And it is, watch. And he lights the f***ing gas.
What?
Stream of f***ing fire shooting out of his cows. But then the gas must have backed up inside or something because the cow f***ing exploded.
Whoa. Okay. Yep. He wasn't lying. That was some story. Nice. You know what? I'm gonna steal that story for when the next time I have a, you know, family meeting. I'm gonna tell that story.
Sorry to hear about your dead missus and all.
Okay, now we're finally getting along.
Sorry about her, ma'am.
Ah, no loss.
Okay, so husband didn't get back into the train. Oh, no. Oh, don't tell me he's a wanted felon. Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa. Oh, Sonny. Even while he's dying, he has jokes.
You know what I mean? Like, just...
No, don't be stupid. Don't do it, don't do it, don't do it. Sonny, don't do it. That's the rabbit?
There's one for each of us.
One for each of... Yo, your kid, you don't... No, 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 no. Don't do it, man. Oof. Aw, how lucky and unlucky. Who got the short end of the stick?
Oh, Jesus. What a day.
Wow. This, okay, well, still processing it, but I would assume so far it's a short film about mourning death. Ridiculous of, oh well, not so sure what the short film is about, but I would say to keep it short. It's awesome we're going to be checking out short films. I'd have to think this one through. Because I think, you know, with short films, it gives you an opportunity to, like, pose a question. And, you know, I think the main purpose for a short film is to eventually, well, for most people, is to eventually get your own film to become a feature. And part of doing that, you know, is to have an intriguing question at the end. You know, to scratch your head, what was that about? And I think this film, the short film, definitely does that. Because I'd have to think about, you know, the caught deaths and his mother and David. But he survived. Yeah, I'm going to have to think this one through. Let me know what you guys think about this short film. 2004. Won an Academy Award. It was, I mean, I'm pretty sure if I... Yeah, it had some great... I mean, the dialogue was really one-sided with the guy in the green shirt, but other than that, it was... Again, every short film is very unique in itself. I don't think there's no two short films alike. And yeah, let me know which short films you guys like. What are your favorites? And, you know, even the BMW shorts, I want to check those out as well. I think my favorite out of them so far is the one directed by Wong Kar-wai. Just the pacing of that one is just superb. But yeah, I'd love to check on more short films, even like this one. I mean, it's a real thought provoker, and you know, I think it's great to keep checking out short films, you know, not only feature films and genre films. It's also, you know, you need to pay respects to shorter pieces of, not content, but shorter pieces of cinema. And, you know, Martin Scorsese and a lot of different directors, they've done extensive work. Because I know Martin Scorsese with the Criterion, he has gone around the world, and if I'm not mistaken, specifically Africa, to collect short films and document them and find places where they can live. And Criterion itself has a number of short films that they have restored. And you know, you love to see this type of love going into, you know, not only feature films, not only animated films, but you know, even, you know, shorts. And you know, it's, you know, there's still some directors that as they're making feature films still go back to short films, because it really sets you in a good foundation. It's very foundational. And you know, apart from, you know, telling stories in 6 seconds, if you can tell it in several minutes, that's, you know, it's masterful storytelling. And I think it was, what is his name, Ridley Scott, who mentioned, you know, short films are way harder, and because he was talking from the perspective of advertising, he said, you know, blowing up something short to a longer version is so much easier because you have so much more filler space and so much more breathing room, whereas when it's short, it has to be bang, bang, bang. Everything has to be concise, and it has to be the best version of itself. No filler, all meat. And I like that perspective. I'm not so sure if I completely agree with it, because at the same time, you're doing a feature, it's that much more of a task to keep and to retain somebody's attention. But I guess you have the auteur, you know, argument, as in, you know, if you like that director, if you like said director, you're gonna watch a 3-hour, 4-hour cut of their film. But again, if we're just looking at this as a, you know, a consumer, what a normal, you know, everyday consumer watching a short film, I can see, well, this definitely is a head scratcher to think what was the whole point. I'm sure once I settle down with it and think about it, I'll get to an interpretation. But you know, short films are important, and I hope to make this a weekly thing where we can continually, you know, share short films, watch them, talk about them, and, you know, give them their due credit. So I hope all of you are doing well, are continuing to give film a good name, and enjoying it, staying healthy, and above all, you're happy, because we're going to have a lot more fun. All right? Peace.